Bienvenidos. ¿Cómo está, mi amigas y amigos? Espero que lo estás haciendo bien. Welcome. How are you, my friends? I hope you are doing well. Welcome to another Let's Eat, where I am going to be obviously eating once again some authentic Mexican food. And the reason that I'm doing another Mexican food episode is because I feel bad for some of the mispronunciations and things. I was out of sorts in the last video where I was eating the Mexican tacos, which reminds me, for all of you bastardos and bastardas that gave this gringo a hard time because I couldn't pronounce jarritos, I got something special for you. Just hold on a second. How the heck is it? There. Oh, here it is. There you go. I'm just kidding. Well, not really. Let's get started. Let me open this up and take a look. And then what I'm going to do is eat this, drink the Jarritos guava. And then at the very end, when I'm done, I'm going to just play around and try to solve the Rubik's Cube. Have a nice day. Thank you. Looks like they also want me to recycle the bag and keep it away from babies. Let's get the Jarritos opened. And I was trying to say that in the last Let's Eat episode, my mind was out of sorts for whatever reason. I mean, I can speak basic Spanish, basic, you know, but as with anything, use it or lose it. So I don't really use Spanish ever in my everyday life. So, and I knew J's are like H's, and V is B, and all that, but. So I have two gorditas. They are, they gave me some sour cream on the side. I'm not really into sour cream or cream cheese, or mayo. And I think I have some extra guacamole. Now, I was going to do a character in this episode, but like I said, because the was the last one, I, screwed some things up a little bit. Oh, and by the way, chorizo, I think that's how you pronounce it. I know it's Spanish sausage, but they also have a Mexican version. Because the place I go to, the authentic Mexican place, has printed on their menus Mexican sausage next to chorizo. I was gonna show you a close-up, but this is all you would really see because the gordita has everything packed inside. It's lettuce. I think there's a cheese in here, refried beans, and then el or lo pastor, or I think it's lo pastor, roasted pork. There's guacamole in here, and one or two other items, but fairly basic, and it's a crispy flour shell, I guess you would say. So hope you can join along with whatever the heck you're eating. Bon appetit. Bon appetit. I can never say that right. I'm American. I'm a gringo. Delicious. And thanks to some of your comments, apparently they have Mexican food in other parts of the world besides the United States. Wow. Again, I get narrow vision. My thought is very closed, and I think it was because it was a new environment that I was recording in. I had a lot on my mind. You won't get grossed out, but you can see the inside of the gordita. The lettuce, some crumbled cheese, looks like. I forgot to look at the ingredients again. I think there's some onion, maybe. Then there looks like refried beans mixed with the roasted pork in the bottom. I mean, I know they sell different foods all across the globe. I just don't know why I didn't think they would sell Mexican food anywhere else besides the United States and Mexico. It's just kind of a weird. But thanks though for those of you bringing that to my attention, that you can find Mexican food apparently in Canada. I think in the UK, maybe. I'm not really sure. I forget where else. But think that's guacamole. Pretty sure. Yeah. So I'm gonna take some of this. They said they put guacamole in here, but I don't really see it. I was gonna slather it on top, but put it inside. I'll save the other half for the other gordita. I'm not sure if I'll get to it, but I am kinda hungry. So I hope wherever you live, cheers, by the way, I hope wherever you live you get a chance to, or you have an opportunity to try some different foods from different, cultures. This is guava jarritos. So what is your favorite type of food? Or you don't have to tell me where you live, but you want to drop a comment and tell me your favorite type of food without giving away your location. I would love to hear. I love almost anything edible. Plant, animal. I love lots of vegetables. Can't speak. I love all kinds of vegetables for the most part. Spinach, collard greens, corn, tomato. Although tomato is like technically a fruit, I think. There are some foods that I haven't had. I haven't had real Chinese or Asian food. I've always had that, what they call the Chinese American. The egg foo young, sweet and sour pork. So next video is going to be a character. Next episode of this series. Then after that, I'm going to try some authentic Japanese or Chinese, if I can. As close to authentic, besides, sweet and sour chicken. And I don't know about you. I'd love to hear, though, what makes you happy? What's the one thing that makes you happy? Do you love food like I do? I know there's a lot of people out there who are picky. And I probably was a little bit as a kid. mean, I love food. I mean, I love the arts. I love music, movies, books. You know, all that. And I love food just as much, but I probably love a good meal. I would think that's maybe everyone likes a really delicious meal, right? That was absolutely delicious. I got one left. Got some cucumber. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to just put this inside the gordita or just eat it as a side. This one looks like it's almost falling apart. A little bit here at the end. There we go. Some grease. Looks like maybe it's from the, you can see. A little greasy. And I'm assuming it's from their roast pork, probably. So, mi amigos, y mi amigas. I hope things are going well for you. Hopefully the weather is nice where you are. It's getting a little sketchy here. So if you hear wind in the background, I hope it's not too bothersome. And which is why I'm not whispering too much. Was absolutely quiet, then I might whisper, but I kind of want to speak a little above the background sounds. I don't know if you can see that, but that's just a little bit of the roast pork. Oh, look. No cilantro on my pinky finger. Now I wish that every day you walk out into the street and there's just food vendors lined up and down of every kind of culture, every day. No McDonald's, no pricey restaurants, reasonably priced food, you know? Like it must have been a long time ago. Hundreds or thousands of years ago, I don't know. Mexican and original, you know, authentic Asian and, I don't know, Polish, Irish. Wouldn't that be awesome? Almost every food choice that you could imagine. A little bit of pasta, a little bit of, Irish stew, a little bit of sushi, you know, some for the omnivores, some for the meat eaters, some for the vegans, vegetarians. Do we really want and really need? We don't need. I'm not gonna get too political, but all people need is food. It doesn't have to be good food. It doesn't have to be cuisine. That's all we need. The basics. Shelter. You know, from the elements, food, something to do would be nice. It'd be great just to be able to, like, I guess my ideal world, if I could, you know, would be just enough leisure time for you to do what you want. Time where you contribute to society, you know. Farming or cooking, something like that. Or unless the leisure time thing that you do contributes to society in some way. You know, you paint and then you want to eat, so you trade your painting for some food or some clothing. I mean, we all I know that I'm kind of thinking and talking probably in, you know, socialist or communist terms. But I just like to see that for everybody, you know? Is that so bad? Is that so wrong? I know it's not that easy. I know that's where we came from. That's where we started out. I think a system of barter and fair trade is where it's at, you know? Isn't that what it's like for the Amish? They all help to build each other's homes. I'm not sure if they still do that. I'm not sure how much land they have or, but I think I might have gotten that from that movie, Witness, with Harrison Ford. Maybe that's a misconception, I don't know. Alright, I forgot my guacamole. I got like one more bite here. I'm just saying, you know, people's lives, especially when it comes to food, shouldn't be so dependent upon how much money they have, you know? not saying everybody should get something for free. I mean, maybe there's nothing wrong with that, but if we all grew up, if we were all born and raised in a society where we all contribute, you wouldn't know any different. It's like being born and raised on a farm. You know, from the very young age, that's the mentality, that's the lifestyle that you lead. Here in the United States, in, you know, these cities and suburbs that we live in, or other parts of the world, you don't live on a farm. What do? You go to school, and then you have some leisure time, and then you get a job, right? So if, and I said I wasn't going to get political, right? Well, no, so. All right, one last bite. Fairness. That's all, man. Fairness. I'm gonna stop. Because if I don't, I'm gonna start talking about things that are not very relaxing to talk about. So. About 56 sugars, which is about a candy bar. So it looks like I got some walking to do. Yeah, walk it off. You can't walk things off. You gotta do a lot of rigorous exercise to burn off all those calories. All right, let me try and wipe my hands off a little better. And like I said, like I promised, I thought just to end this, to add a few more extra minutes of some relaxing sounds. I just fiddle with the Rubik's Cube. I can probably solve one side. I doubt I'll be able to even solve two. I know there's a method to it. You gotta match up all the corners first or something like that. Maybe I'll look into that one day. Anyway, thank you for joining me. I hope you got a chance to eat something along with me and that you enjoyed it. Again, love to hear anything you have to say in the comments about, you know, the types of food that you enjoy. If you ever have a chance to try something new. And that's really it. So stay tuned for the next episode in about a week or two, which will probably be, a certain character. So until then, take care of yourself, stay well, and I wish you all my best. See you later. Okay, so I got a two white there. I flip that way. All right, so I just need three more. So I got one here. I need to get it here. So I think I have to go like this. And then like that. I got this one here. So I think, let's see, how am I gonna get that? I need to get this middle one in between these two. I think it's the same method. Yeah. If I get that middle one, now I got that middle one right here. I need to get it need to get it there. So I think it's the same principle, sort of. Yep. Bring those three together and then slide. There we go. I got one side now. Okay. I gotta try to do another side. There's no way I'm gonna be able to do this. I don't think. I mean, there is a way I'm gonna be able to do it, but without messing up the whites. Let's see if I can get the orange. I'm not gonna be able to do this. I'm not that smart. Okay. How do I get this middle one into with these without messing up all the white? I mean, it's gotta be that same principle. Okay, there we go. See, now I got the white ones out of the alignment. Now I gotta bring those back. If I bring those back, that's gonna screw everything up that I just did to get the orange together. Maybe I'm supposed to bring the orange. See, I have an orange right against the white here, and then I have two orange against these white. So should I try to build it this side or this side? I don't know. How am I gonna get that one? This up online and cheat and figure out how to solve a Rubik's Cube by cheating. So I don't know how I'm gonna get these. Boy, that's a tough one. I have to get this white one. It's got the orange side to it. Somehow. All right, now I got them on opposite sides. So I gotta get this white piece back in the middle. I'm gonna do that. Where's that white one? Now I gotta get all of that. To getting that white one. I gotta get that white one back in the middle here. So how do I do that? Okay. Bring the white back here. Okay, that's good. Alright, so now I got all three orange ones that are connected to the white right there. So that's good. Now gotta get this white one, this orange one, and this orange one, and this orange one over 2-3 spots without messing up the white too much. That should be very hard for my little monkey brain.